Hi, this is Dr. Patrick Cohn with Soccer Psychology Tips, along with Jackie Hitzelberger, our mental game expert for soccer. Today we have a short video on the difference between reactive confidence and proactive confidence for soccer players. We're previewing a new CD and workbook program titled Soccer Confidence Mental Toughness Strategies for a Competitive Edge. Now we want you to understand that there's two main types of confidence that you want to be aware of. One, which is not the best option, is called reactive confidence. The other, the one you really want to embrace in soccer, is called proactive confidence. Let's go over and start with some of the qualities of reactive confidence. If you're the type of player that lacks confidence after a poor practice session prior to a game and you react negatively, that's obviously reactive confidence and not desired. You're affected by a poor warm-up, or you're intimidated by the competition. Those are a couple other ways you might have this reactive confidence. You're reacting to what's happening around you, such as the competition, and you're reacting to how you're feeling about your warm-up. We find that players that can only be confident after the first few plays of the game, they allow their confidence to be dictated by their immediate performance. In other words, they're reacting again. Players who are affected by negative feedback, obviously they're reacting to feedback from others. Players who lose confidence quickly after mistakes, that's another sign of reactive confidence. Basically, this group right here, if you fall into reactive confidence, you're leaving your confidence to chance. You're not taking full responsibility for your confidence, which really is the topic of proactive confidence. Proactive confidence are the players that are consistent performers. If you feel confident going into a game, you have a 10 out of 10 on the confidence scale at the start of the game, well, that's a good sign that you have a full tank of confidence when you start the game. If your confidence is more stable during the game, that's another great sign that you have proactive confidence. If you focus on your strengths as a player and your skills and your talents and not the other team's talents, that's a good sign as well. If you visualize success, if you feel confident in spite of a poor warm-up, in other words, you can shake off that poor warm-up and still feel confident at the start of the game, that's another great sign that you have proactive confidence. And finally, if you're not intimidated by the competitors and you don't react negatively to other skilled or strong-looking players, that's another great sign that you have more stable level or proactive confidence. Obviously, you don't want to be in the realm of reactive confidence, and you want to be in the realm of having proactive confidence. This is just one of many strategies that we teach you in our new program, Soccer Confidence Mental Toughness Strategies for a Competitive Edge. We're going to release this program next week. If you want to get more information, visit soccerpsychologytips.com and be sure to download our free ebook while you're there, and we'll let you know the moment we have copies ready. Thanks a lot.